Hello, everyone. How are you doing on this beautiful Sunday?
What's up, folks?
Giving y'all a chance to log in. Make sure I have this screen. And my name is Sharonda Parker.
And I'm Spencer Parker, Sharonda Parker's husband.
And we are the owners and operators of the PPG store.
Yeah.
And today we are going to be talking about setting the atmosphere when it comes down to Valentine's Day, some differently things that you can do with water play, bubbles, and some different things you can do as far as romance goes. So you ready to get started this Sunday?
What we could do as far as romance goes.
Romance. Let's talk about romance. One of the first things that you have to do is romance is about scenery and setting the mood, okay? Honestly, as a woman, I don't feel like there's anything romantic about, you know, you walking in and everything is the same. You want to see some candles. You want to see some rose petals. You want to see some dim lights. You want to hear some soft music, you know, something sexy that make you want to just give it up. Like when I hear certain songs, it just make me want to, like, ooh, give it up. Like that song, what'd he say? I don't even be knowing the words to the song. He said, I just want to sex you, babe. And it'd be like the little raindrops in the background. The
do.
Yeah, all that. I just be like, ooh. Pussy just get the, ooh.
Yeah. Okay.
Ooh. Yeah.
So,
And I just think, you know, a lot of it, like I said, has to do with setting the atmosphere. You know, when a woman see like rose petals and little candles everywhere, it's kind of like you took out time to plan something
so
and do something.
Cater to.
Of course.
Yeah, cater to.
Explain it to these men.
Okay.
Explain it to them.
So, fellas, this the game. Women want to be catered to.
Mm-hmm.
All right. But you gotta understand, like, women are women. Women like change also. So keep that in mind.
And men don't.
Yeah. Keep that in mind when you set in the mood, and cause it's gonna have to have a transition up and up. Because like when you set in the mood and you being all romantic, like just remember that at some point in time, like sex is gonna have to take place and you gonna have to transition that romantic side of you to that
beast,
sexual beast that you got inside of you. So the romance gonna have to go out the window once, you know what I'm saying, the actual act start. So what we saying is, like, set the mood, right?
Babe,
but don't
let me ask you this here, because see, you understand what romance is, right? Mm-hmm. But a lot of men is like, all they hearing is the word romance. They don't know. So like, break it down and explain.
So what I'm saying is, like, when you, like, romance, she talking about romance at the extreme, like Valentine's Day type romance, setting the mood.
Yeah,
with
like,
the, but like, I'm talking about everyday romance. Like, you can sit down and have a conversation with your woman, like she say, rub her feet, like, talk to her, like,
yes,
see what happened with her, what's going on in her day, like, totally ignore yourself and see what's going on with her.
Right.
That's what we looking for. That's what she looking for. They want us to ignore us, pay all attention to them, and then beat their brains out when it's all over.
Beat it up.
Yeah. So that's basically it. Like, it ain't got to be no long, drawn out, you know, like, days and days and days. Like, but you got to put the time and the effort in to make sure she is the center of attention.
Yeah.
Like,
but like I said, for us, especially being that we know everybody's trying to prepare for Valentine's Day and stuff like that, for us, scenery is everything. Like, you know, and women, I'ma just throw this out there, okay? Just make sure everything is nice, neat, put away, the clothes put up, like, clean up your house. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's hard to set the mood, you know, for a romantic evening and you got a pile of clothes on the bed. Come on, like, you know, like, you gotta, all that has to take place. But it's almost like you would think that you don't have to tell people this type of stuff.
Yeah.
But you really do have to tell people.
I mean, that's what the the importance of communication is.
Yeah.
Cause like you don't want to get, you want to have all of this stuff already situated. Like you don't want your person to come in and be disappointed because you know the mood you tried to set wasn't the mood that they was going for.
She still looked the same.
Yeah.
You when I left this motherfucker.
Yeah. Man, you got candles all over the place, but you about to burn this bitch down. Cause they, you know, yeah, but like you saying, yeah, you gotta do it correctly. Like, don't have faith with it, cause they gonna know.
Yeah, and another thing, when we talking about like catering to our bodies and stuff like that, because another person on here say, yes, you gotta cater to my body. You know, you gotta
cater to the man first.
You gotta conversate. You know, all of that turns me on before I can give you.
And feelings like we got to understand is like you be thinking like we think, oh, you a beast in the bedroom and all this type of stuff. Nah, man, they just like us. They just love us for who we are. Like your sex game ain't that spectacular. Like you ain't doing all of that, but they love us anyway.
It's a mental connection. It's
so
mental.
The mental connection is real. So what you got to do is cater to that. You know what I'm saying? And know what you're dealing with. Cause like you can't be walking around having them big conversations and you not, you know, there yet. You know what I'm saying? You might have a big package, but you not doing, you know what I'm saying, big package things. So you gotta make sure that everything is taken care of on all fronts. And you gotta make sure that bedroom is one of them. The main thing, you gotta keep that right and tight.
Yeah. So we're gonna talk about some different things that you can incorporate. Some of these items are new that I just got in this week. This week we have the bath bombs in the wine glass. It's 8 of them. Bath bombs, a lot of times people see them in all of the different like Bed Bath & Beyond and all of that kind of stuff. Well, the ones that we have pheromones in them. That's what makes ours different. So they're not going to be like the one that you go get at the, you know, at your regular Walmart or something like that. Yeah, these have pheromones in it. And if you don't know what a pheromone is, pheromones are sexual attractants through smell. Okay? So basically, when she starts to smell the pheromones, it makes her want to freely give it up. It makes him want to freely give it up because that's the purpose of it.
And the good thing about like these pheromones, like if you put this in your bath water, if you and him decide to take a bath together, like believe it or not, when y'all get out these pheromones with your body chemistry, you're gonna have y'all smelling two totally different ways.
Yeah, because what it does to my body is gonna be completely different than his because we have two different pHs. So that's the great thing about pheromones. It's gonna smell completely different on each person. Okay? Then we have another bubble bath by Donna. And this one has, oh my God, what is it? It's like a minty type of smell to it. So it's designed to relax you. So this is a more relaxing type bubble bath, okay? So this is something that you can use after a long day of work. This goes beyond Valentine's Day, but this one is more for relaxation. Then we have the champagne bubble bath, which is one of my favorites, and this one is a huge seller this time of year because I'm gonna be honest, a lot of times we'll go to like, we'll go to Avon and we'll get bubble bath, or we'll go to Walmart and get bubble bath, and you put the bubble bath in, and all of a sudden you're noticing, well, my bubbles are starting to disappear before I could even get in the water. Well, this is concentrated bubble bath. So if you ever see in the movies where you have these big old thick fluffy bubbles and you're like, oh my God, how they get their bubbles to do that? Because they're using a pure concentrated bubble bath. So if you want everlasting bubbles, then when you let the water out the tub, you're going to still have a tub full of bubbles. They got to just dissolve. Or you're going to be washing that tub out over and over and over again.
You're going to be washing that over.
Yeah. This is the concentrated bubble bath. Another bubble bath that we have that is extremely popular, glow-in-the-dark bubble bath. You're going to pour this in your bath water like you would normally do. Mm-hmm. You're going to get in and you're going to bathe like you normally do. You're going to get out. Mm-hmm. You're going to air dry. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, I didn't say with a towel. You're going to air dry. You're going to walk into your dark room and voila.
Yep.
The whole body gonna be glowing.
Yeah, jump on that thing and do what you do. What you don't do is get your ass up and go to the movies afterwards. You're gonna look like an avatar now.
You're gonna still be glowing, okay? So this takes a little while to wear off the skin, but it's the men love it. Especially if they don't even know it's coming.
Yeah,
you walk your naked ass up in there and you glowing. Oh, shit.
Just turn around and make that ass wild before one good time. Get your rent, light bill, house paid off, whatever you need.
You're gonna be doing the butterfly hug.
The bud just bought the Benz, the 500 series.
Then I have another pheromone-infused bubble bath. And this one is the sweet tea. Not the sweet tea, the sweet pea. That's the smell it is. That's not sweet tea, sweet pea. Sweet pea is a fragrance that they sell at Bath and Body Works. So it's a common fragrance. So this is new to the PPG store. We just started carrying this week for Valentine's Day. But this is a pheromone-infused bubble bath as well. All right, let's see what y'all saying. Glow in the dark. Y'all got the smiley faces. And we love you, too. Let me slide this to the side. We went last night with our marriage ministry. And we gave out, little gifts or whatever. But let me tell you something about couponing, because I know a lot of y'all coupon and y'all stockpile it, dishwashing liquid and washing powder and anything you can use to clean your house with. That's what they do with the coupon. We got a different set of coupons. When you come in and you see this little mailbox, it's because it's full of coupons, okay? This book has 100 of them in there. And they tell you to do a variety of things like,
some of everything. It be telling you to go in your washroom and do stuff like
sit on the wash machine, put it on spin. It tell you to feed that pussy to them. It tell you to give blowjobs in the middle of games.
You name it.
Anything is 100 different coupons that's in here. So the way this goes is when you or your man is down like this here, but when you see that it's up like that, that's telling you one thing. Somebody got some mail in there.
You
need to check your mailbox, because it's something that's going to go on when you check this mailbox, okay? So you don't know what it is this person have planned for you. And this is something that y'all could do all throughout the year with this mailbox, because it's 100 different coupons in there.
So look. This is something that y'all can use all throughout the year. But let me tell you something about this coupon book. It ain't for y'all to be mad, bickering, and fighting and fussing and arguing when it's time to redeem these mugs. All right? So look, y'all had a conversation about y'all coupons, right? And be willing to redeem them when it's time to redeem them, because that's all of the fun. It's not no fun if you're gonna give the coupons out for that pussy and then when I come to collect, you talking about I'm tired, boss.
Yeah.
Put your ass on the gun line and shoot at you.
Or either, a lot of them have stuff like, do a sexy striptease. I was talking to one of my church members this morning, and she was saying, girl, it's time for me to re-up my lingerie game, because a lot of times when women get married, they get a lot of lingerie, right? But the thing is, every now and then, you want to surprise him with something new, And it's not saying that the old lingerie don't work, because people be like, well, I got so much of it. But ain't nothing like a new piece of lingerie. So when you pull that one that say a sexy striptease, that's when you know, okay, I got to go and run and pick me up something cute to put on and do that little dance. And stop being so self-conscious and shame. Like, so what if you can't dance?
Fuck, I ain't gonna lie.
Don't nobody care. Y'all, I can't dance.
Y'all be
finished. But I know how to wipe that ass.
Y'all want us to go above and beyond. We be like, man, just do a little something. Y'all be talking, I'm too fat to wear this. I'm too fat to wear this.
I've been there. But guess what? One thing about it, I don't care how big I was, I dressed that shit up, because he knew all of them rolls was there before he was going to even get in. Because he knew the rolls was there.
Yeah.
So what do y'all be thinking? Because the men know the rolls there. Y'all, what?
I like them.
Babe, I had put a body stocking on one year, a crotchless one. Sure did. The ones that them strippers be wearing, the all into one. Oh, then one year, remember I brought you to the store, and he said, stay in the car, I need to run in and get something. And he was running in to get what he wanted to see me in, right? I ought to go out there and get it, huh? Mm-hmm. I'm right back. But I'm gonna show you what he got.
She gonna show y'all what I got. But anyway, like I was saying, this was when she was what, 300 pounds plus?
350 pounds down there.
Look, if we with you, we with you. All that self-conscious, oh, I don't look right in this and I don't look right in that. Look, it's a lot of stuff y'all don't look right in sometimes, but like when we getting ready to get that ass, like we don't care. Like we wanna see you in what we wanna see you in.
All right. This is called the motherfucking slingshot. Yeah. And you wear it like, okay, and keep in mind, I was 350 pounds, okay?
Yeah.
And you wear it, and this goes over the breast, and this part come up the back like a thong. So, this all of it. This is it.
I ain't come up here and get a goddamn thing to cover up now.
No. He came and got a slingshot, and guess what? I kept it on the whole time we was having sex, and he pulled the little string to the side, and he had something to hold on to when he was getting in there. Boy, he was giving these strings hell.
I got the same color
because his favorite color pink. So I went and got exactly what you got, the slingshot.
Yeah.
And this is one size fit everybody. I don't give a fuck how big or small you is. You can put this slingshot on.
Ain't nothing but a little piece of.
That's it. And I think what make it more fun is when you get the pull a little string. You know what? I'm gonna go get another color one of these.
You know what make it fun? When y'all bring y'all asses out in some stuff y'all don't normally wear, you got 17,000 tons of confidence with that shit.
Confidence to say.
Like, oh my God. Like, it don't matter. Like, she 350 pounds. Like, it don't matter. Like, you come out with confidence, that's my baby. That's my wife. Fuck what anybody got to say about that. That's
Thank
my
you.
350 pounds of all kind of rolls. I love every inch, every millimeter, centimeter.
Yep.
Roll it around and come bouncing over here.
So yeah, just so you know, y'all, what sexy is your attitude, your confidence, the way you wear it. That's what sexy. So,
if you ain't that woman that's confident in the bedroom, like, get you some and go ahead for Valentine's Day, reverse the roles. And when he think he about to dominate you, you go ahead and show him some sports and watch how they turn out for you.
Because, you know, I be having men that be talking like they want to be not raped for real, but they be like, I want her to take it from me. Like, just for once,
We be wanting y'all to do the same thing y'all be wanting us to do to y'all. Like, we come in and take it when we want to take it. Like, why y'all can't do the same thing?
You better take that, dude. I mean, literally take it from him. Not you take it. Like, you take his from him and be like, this is my dick.
Don't wait during the Super Bowl or the playoffs. Because you're going to cause a problem. Like, you know, wait till you're watching something that ain't all of that. You know what I'm saying? Or doing something that ain't all of that. And put his mind on something else. Free him up a little bit.
Yes, indeed. All right, let's see. That's how I used to be. Walk in the room, covering up my stomach. And he'll be like, bring that sexy kangaroo pouch here. Made me laugh and made Lord me feel Jesus. Good at the same time. You miss my flute, but I call it a flute. What you call it, baby?
A chalupa.
he missed my chalupa.
Lord, y'all, look, she went and got all that shit cut off.
I did.
And she tried to hop on top of me, and I was like, oh, Lord. This shit don't feel right. I'm gonna break her. Where is my rose that used to be here? Because I miss this shit.
Goodness.
I miss my rose.
I miss his rose. All right.
Mass.
Yes, mass. This one is a great accent. It comes in black, red, and white. This is a great accent piece to your lingerie.
Oh, my
this
God.
This just dresses it on up. This along with some... See, when you're doing lingerie, you got to do the lingerie. And you got to do accessories. You got to do the lace mask. You got to do the thigh-high stockings.
Yes.
A nice, sexy heel. Like, when you see me posing and doing my photo shoots,
I don't know,
stuff,
but, like...
You got to...
I think all men go crazy behind lace. Like, am I the only one? Because, like, you put on some fucking lace and it don't matter. Like, it's all the way up.
Then we have the blindfold, which I absolutely love because you don't know what's coming.
And see, people be sleeping on the blindfold, like, during sex. You be talking about, oh, I don't want to. But, like, the element of surprise, when you're dealing with somebody you trust, it could be very sexy. So if you're dealing with them and all they try to do is please you and you blindfold and you don't know where their next move coming from, you think about that.
Hmm.
You might have a good night. You just might have a good night. You know what I'm saying? That boy get down there and touch the right places while you're blindfolded.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This. this massage candle, light it and drip some of that wax, what, blindfold her and drip some of that down in the thighs.
Tell her you about to drip some wax on her.
And you ain't got to say nothing. Just do it. Just do it. And tell her, just tell her to bust that pussy.
And watch her squirm and squeam and like, oh my God, he about to burn my ass alive. And pull this on and rub it in. Like.
But, you know, I like you to talk real nasty to me. I be wanting you to dog my ass out, tell me some more shit, fuck my mind up. But everybody ain't like that.
We is keeping it
Valentine's Day, but you know.
You know, when we get to talking about this shit here, I get excited about the change.
But I'm just saying, you know, like women, you tell a woman, girl, bust that pussy open. That shit make our heart race. We be like, ooh.
Who the fuck, they ain't telling them that.
Who ain't?
Them men ain't telling them no shit like that.
Them men ain't telling y'all to bust
No, they ain't telling y'all no
what
shit.
What they saying,
like
you gonna give me a little bit? I don't like you to talk elementary like that.
They walk around like
shit. Don't say that elementary, you gonna give me a little
cat. They walk around talking about, I wonder when we gonna have sex.
No, I don't like them terms, cat and, you know, coochie and a little bit. I don't like saying what it is.
When it's up, it's up. Like, y'all can't be walking around for 2 or 3 months at a time, not getting none, 2 or 3 weeks, 2 or 3 days, if that's not what you want. You tell her, well, look, I done been more than patient. You understand?
Waiting on that what?
Waiting on that pussy. It's time for you. You need to come on and do something. You need to go ahead, bust that pussy, open that mouth, something. Like, I need some relief. You gotta make a closed mouth, don't get fed. Mm. You understand? And if you open your mouth, you can feed her up.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
She gonna eat it all up. Churn and grain churn. Yes, indeed. Last but not least.
Look at that cup.
Yeah, these the fur ones, because a lot of times people get intimidated about the metal handcuffs.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all. Look, it took me a long time to get to the point where I could talk about handcuffs, because see... I got a trouble pass. But look, like, I done embraced the handcuffs, because when you ain't doing nothing to be putting these permanently, you ain't got to worry about that type of stuff.
That's right.
Now, you know, I got a whole nother outlook on handcuffs and this whole bondage and submission thing, because it could be very, 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 very exciting.
Yes. I think more mentally exciting than anything.
I think Fifty Shades Freed is going to be a good movie. All off subject, but you know, the 50 Shades of Grey trilogy, the book was excellent. The movies flopped. They was royal bullshit.
Compared to the book.
I think this last one gonna do a little something.
Well, we're gonna have to check it out and see.
On the other things. The PPG store is doing a lot of big things for y'all for Valentine's Day. We got all kind of products, new stuff up in here for y'all. Mm-hmm. Carry throughout the year. We get new stuff in every week, though, so that ain't nothing new. Y'all come in, check us out, see what y'all got, add to y'all collection. Stop by, mm-hmm. Shoot shit, whatever.
We'll just be open to 5 today.
Yeah.
And you can get on the phone and call 225-663-2982. And you can order your chocolate covered strawberries. All we need is your name, your number, pickup date and time, and let us know if you're doing a tray or a dozen. Just know that whatever time you give us for pickup, we hold them for an hour. After that, we're going to start advertising that they for sale. Simple as that. We normally don't have any problems. Most of the time, the problem is we don't have enough strawberries for everybody that want them. So
we got nothing but the baskets in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got the baskets. Yep. You got the corsets. You need a corset.
Baskets, corsets, lingerie, thigh high stocking shoes, anything you can think of, chains and whips, inflatables,
shock
position aids, sex wings, you name it, we got it.
We got that cock shocker. Hey, shout out to y'all who came and got the cock shocker. I thought I was the only person in Baton Rouge that was into that kinky shit. Y'all proved me wrong, so shout out to the people out there who like me, who like to get real nasty and don't give a fuck what y'all think about it.
And you can shop online www.theppgstore.com.
Yeah.
And